Alright, Greg in Real Life back here. We're gonna pick up right back up on Heavy Rain. So yeah, let's get into it. We just finished that fight in, I believe it was like Lauren or something. We beat up her guy that comes back for her. Look at that nice face right there. Got a nice face there, buddy. Tuesday, we're driving to a crime scene, it looks like. Dude, shaking. What's up with that? Am I playing as someone else now?
Noted that name somewhere. What was it?
Blake. Lieutenant Carter Blake, yeah, that's it.
Reporters. Already.
Huh. I don't know, I'm just walking around, just, I don't know, seeing whatever's, interesting.
Goddamn rain. Hasn't stopped pouring since I arrived. I'm really gonna love it here.
I guess we're supposed to go this way, so let's go.
Yes, Joe. A body was found here on this patch of wasteland early this morning.
The zone is sectioned off, sir. Please step back.
Agent Norman Jaden.
Guess we're Norman Jaden.
You got a badge or something, Mr. Jaden?
Yeah. Yeah, of course.
Check. You can pass.
You're goddamn right again.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Blake. Is he around?
I saw him arrive earlier. He's here somewhere.
Thanks. God, my hands are trembling. I gotta keep my act together. At least for now.
Like, so I'm just searching, I don't know. If there's anything I can do or look at, so. Oh. The fuck are these?
Video memo recording, Agent 47023, Nam and Jaden, Tuesday, October 4th, 2011. Time is 8:14 a.m.
Okay. I'm looking for Lieutenant Carter Blake.
Found him.
Thanks.
Married comment, sample of no interest, comes from one of the policemen present on the wasteland.
don't know. I'm just searching to see if there's any like clue.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Carter Blake.
This is for, oh. He's right in front of my fucking face.
Poor Thanks. Joke. Lieutenant Blake, I'm Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI. I went by your office this morning. They told me to be here.
Now, if you're looking for rain, dead bodies, and highways, you come to the right place. Mike, will you tell that asshole with the bulldozer to stop for 5 minutes? I can't hear myself think here.
Right away, Lieutenant.
Well, are you coming, Jaden?
So, what happened?
Some guy taking his dog for a piss found a body about 6 o'clock this morning. We don't know much more right now. Based on what we've seen, looks like the work of the origami killer.
Has the time of death been established?
Based on the rigor mortis, must be less than 6 hours ago. We should know more once the coroner has had a look. Any news on the coroner?
He's on his way, Lieutenant.
We've been waiting for an hour, for fuck's sake.
Do we know the cause of death?
There are no marks on the body. Chances are he was drowned, like the others.
Has the body been identified?
No, not yet. We should know more later today.
Do you have any leads?
My men are going over the scene with a fine-tooth comb. If the killer left anything behind, we'll find it. Tony, I don't want to see a single shit-stirring journalist within a mile of here. You got it?
Yes, Lieutenant.
There are a lot of people on the crime scene. Aren't you afraid your men might destroy some clues?
You don't find proof sitting behind a desk. We're not in the habit of trampling things into the ground, even if we're not in the end.
Well, fuck you.
No, of course not. That's not what I meant.
Listen, I'm a little busy here. Why don't we discuss all this a little later, back at the office?
Oh, no problem. I understand. Do you mind if I have a look around?
Be my guest. Hey, Jaden. You come and see me if you find anything, okay? We're on the same team now.
Gotta find clues.
Harry, come. Sample of no interest. Comes from one of the policemen present on the waste ramp.
Some orchid pollen. The concentration of pollen in the air is quickly decreasing because of the rain, but it gets higher in the direction of the body.
Airy comment. The pollen particles disappear in the tall grass. It's probably the end of the trail.
Wanna walk, fuckhead? Jesus Christ.
Way too many people here. They're trampling all over the crime scene. There's a railroad track near where the body was left. Same as all the other victims.
A dead cat. The FBI doesn't keep files on dead cats. Not yet.
The body is still here. Strange character, that Blake. Didn't seem too pleased to see me.
Harry, comment. Traces of blood detected on the fence behind the railroad line. The blood report indicates an advanced and long-lasting state of exhaustion.
Oh, come on, dude. Find an alternative route. Oops. I'm a fuckhead for that. Alright, let's try again, big boy. I like how interactive this game is, though. These parts are, like, really fun to do. Oh, they changed it up there. You got me. Don't slip down the mud, man. Bad for business.
There's a good chance that they're the killers.
Was this toxic waste?
Harry, come in. Tire tracks on the side of the boat behind the railroad line. It may be the killers.
Save us. There is. Is there anything else?
Why the hell is there blood here? Orchid pollen. Something the killer couldn't control. Can be traced back to its source? Body is still here.
Alright, well, I'm gonna go back down, I guess. I don't really see anywhere else to go over here. Dumb. sliding like a champion. Oh. That's alright. That's alright, pal.
Body is still here. I could use a coffee. Might warm me up.
When did they find the body?
Excuse me, but who are you exactly?
Norman Jaden, FBI.
If you want to ask questions, you should speak to Lieutenant Blake, sir.
Pretty chilly, huh? Lousy weather, huh? Does it always rain like this?
It rains every fall. Doesn't it do that where you come from?
Well, yeah. Yeah, of course. Is that a coffee you're drinking there?
There's some in the thermos behind you. Help yourself.
Don't mind if I do, thank you.
Back to the office. You staying?
Yeah, I'm gonna have another look around if you don't mind.
Take all the time you want.
Trying to find this freaking body, bruh.
Harry, comment. Sample of no interest. Comes to one of the policemen present on the wasteland.
Thought I hit a break right there. Guess not. Fuck me. Jeez, man.
Footprints continue just after the pollen trail. There's a good chance that they're the killers.
Don't know what to do, where to go. Maybe I should have left. I'm not sure.
Oh.
pass.
There's a good chance that they're the killers.
This is actually very frustrating.
Harry Common. The victim is lying on his back. No visible signs of violence.
Alright. This is kind of cool, like this whole
thing. Orchid was placed on the victim's chest.
Oh, the origami.
A small origami figure in the right hand. Fingers were probably closed after the time of death. Superficial wound on the right thigh. The blood is identical to that on the fence. His face is covered with mud, like the other victims. The victim is Jeremy Bowles, declared missing 5 days ago. See reference file. I think I've seen all there is to see. Impressive. Seems the only traces the killer left are those he intended to leave. He knew exactly what he was doing. Right down to the tiniest detail. I think I've seen enough. Better get back to the station before I catch pneumonia. The trail leads to this ridge. The killer must have come down here with a body. The trail leads to this ridge. The killer must have come down here with a body.
Goddamn right he did. Gonna drive off to the sunset. Literally have to start the car for him. Come on, man. What are we, new? I've unlocked a new bonus. Yay! I see a bat.
A bat.
I see a wolf.
A wolf's head.
I actually see a crab.
A crab.
I see death.
Death. Death.
I have the results of your MRI scans. Everything seems to be normal. There is no physical damage from the accident. However, I am worried about your psychological condition. I know it's not easy, but you've got to start over, Ethan. You're not responsible for what happened.
It's my fault Jason is dead. He'd still be alive if I'd been looking out for him.
It was an accident. Accidents happen every day. You can't blame yourself forever for your son's death.
Yes, I can.
How is Sean?
He's a very solitary kid, you know, very focused within himself. He's really close to his mother. With me, he's more distant.
And what about you, Ethan? What do you feel?
I no longer want to live. I have no reason to continue.
Not even for your son, Sean.
I couldn't save Jason. Sean doesn't need a father like me.
That's deep.
Is there something else you wanted to tell me, Ethan?
No. No.
That's the end of this session. We'll continue this conversation next week. You were lucky, Ethan. It's very rare to survive such a traumatic accident.
I don't exactly feel lucky, Doctor.
Nearly an inch of rain. That's not good.
Is something the matter, Sean?
No, I'm all right.
Do you want to eat something? Aren't you going to go play with the other kids?
I don't feel like it.
How did things go at school today?
The teacher yelled at me for being late again. She's gonna send me home the next time it happens.
I'm sorry about that, Sean. Next time, we'll really pull it together, okay?
What am I going to do to cheer him up?
I haven't been on a seesaw in a long time. What do you think?
Yeah!
About to seesaw with my boy Sean, you know?
Come on, Dad, make me fly!
Yeah, making my son fly, not a big deal, making him fly, fly. Made him laugh, look at him, he looks happy.
Maybe you're right on the merry-go-round.
What about that merry-go-round? I bet I can push you so fast you won't be able to stay on it.
Great!
Today, you little fuck. Mash, 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 mash.
Come on, Dad, as fast as you can. Faster! Faster! Come on, faster, faster!
This is giving me a workout. I got dizzy, fuck.
Good training for astronauts, though.
Maybe he'd like to have a turn on the swings.
You want to go play on the swing? I'll push you.
Okay.
Okay. Gonna push my little guy. Get on there, kid. Oh, I gotta hold it. Durr.
You're not pushing dead.
Fucked up, son. I fucked up. I fucked up, son, again. I fucked up.
Come on, Dad. Higher.
The fuck? Why won't it do it?
I don't want to play that game anymore.
Looks like rain's coming. I think we better go.
Okay.
I'm kinda mad that that swing fucked up. Now he's all mad, I'm mad.
You know, sometimes I remember before. I mean, when Jason was still here. Sometimes I wish everything could just be the way it was before.
Me too, buddy.
Me too, Sean. Me too.
Let's go, Shawnee. Lead the way, pal.
Hey, Dad, can I have a ride on the carousel? Can I?
Sure. Go pick a horse and get on. I'll get a ticket. One, please.
$1 for a ride, hell yeah. Oh, that dollar looks nice, though. Where's pal? Come here, buddy. Enjoying a nice little carousel there, riding his horsey. I'm about to have an episode of my, Schizophrenia. I'm about to black out right here. It's like he just did cocaine and his nose is bleeding. Oh! Hand was not on the controller for that one. Dude, like, no one's there. You think he's really gonna be there? What if he was, like, still there, just, like, sitting there on the horse? Like, hey, Dad. You piece of shit, you forgot me. I don't know where to go. Where do I go?
Sean, where are you?
Run out.
Sean!
Pal! Am I running back home? looks like it. Can you imagine, like, you know, having your one kid, like, basically die in your arms and then just, like, missing your other kid and having him go, like, just disappear with a fucking origami in your hand and you have no idea what the fuck it means? Like, how would you feel? I don't know how I would feel. This dude doesn't even know how he feels right now. That's some shit. That's some bad luck. Bad luck Ethan Mars. That's his new name. Bad luck Ethan Mars. .3 inches. That's not good. Alright, well, I'm gonna stop this part here and then we can pick up on part 4 next time. As always, thank you for watching. I appreciate it. Like, comment, subscribe, and as always, stay tuned for more gameplay videos, more updates from Greg in real life. Yeah, thank you for viewing.